Hey, Heilala TV. My name is Monna Haverly, and welcome to my
all
city of Seattle.
Island girls, the most precious thing in the world.
I'm Tongan and we live in Seattle. We're a very diverse community here. Every culture is accepted and loved. We're not too bougie over here. So, you know, Seattle's known for its rain. Seattle's known for the Space Needle. This waterfront, this beautiful waterfront. There's really a lot of things to do here, whether it be nightlife or hiking. If you're a tree hugger, we got a lot of stuff for you to do over here. A lot of great restaurants, and pretty much I think the thing that bothers me the most, like the biggest misconception, because I'm so light, that they think that I don't know the Tongan ways or Tongan language or the culture. And that bothers me because I grew up in a straight Tongan household. You know, my mom's hitting me with brooms. No, not all that, but you know, we grew up, Tongan was the first language in the house. My dad was a merchant marine, so he was gone half of the year. We grew up doing taulungas and doing the fakame. Grew up coming across the Puget Sound, and I couldn't think of any other place to live. It's a place I'd probably like to move and have a career somewhere else, but I'd always come back to Seattle. So when I went to Tonga, it was nice to see, being like a young teenager or mid-teenager at that time, because I understood everything that was going on, but I got to see the actual richness there. I mean, no matter how much we want to bring Tonga here, it's still all kind of fabricated compared to, you know, you can only make it so much Tonga. So actually being there, enriched me a lot, and I would never trade it. You know, it's just, you go to the store, they're speaking Tongan. You know, you're out in the street, they're speaking Tongan. So, you know, of course, you're gonna develop your skills a little bit better. And just to see how my mother grew up, it was really important to me, and to see where she grew up at, because there's a difference there. My mom, you know, how Tongan parents are, if they don't really open up to their kids, it's kind of, you work, your kids are not really human beings at that time, they're just your kids, you know, they do what you say. But just actually go there and have that bonding with my mom was really, really important to me, and with my Auntie Yala and stuff like that, just to see where they grew up at, where their stomping grounds were, you know. And I understood a lot better why my mom is the way she is, you know, and or why she has the beliefs that she does, and that sort of thing. So I would suggest and recommend for all of these Tongan parents that came over to America and had kids, take your kids back home.